Omaha, Nebraska, on EWTN's Spirit Radio, 102.7 FM. Hello, Joe.
Hello.
Hey, welcome.
Thanks for taking my call.
You're welcome. We're going to be in your neck of the woods next month, by the way. Just a quick little shame-free ad. Cool. Yep, go ahead.
I have a quick question. With Mary's Immaculate Conception, did she experience temptation? Did she even have the near occasion of sin, or not at all?
No, Joe, she would have been tempted just as her divine son. Now, she did not have concupiscence. She didn't have that fomes peccati in Latin, you know, the tendency to sin that we have due to the fact that we lost the original justice that Adam and Eve had in the garden. We don't have that gift of integrity where the lower appetites are perfectly ordered to the intellect and the will. Mary would have had that, but she still would have been tempted just as Jesus was. And if you notice, when the devil tempted Jesus, if you go to Matthew chapter 4 and you see the temptations, he doesn't appeal to the lower nature. He knows he can't. So it's to pride. It's, you know, if you're this, and the scripture says, you know, he will Psalm 91, he will protect you, then leap off of this building. See, leap from this temple. He's tempting him in accordance with the higher powers that Jesus has, his intellect and will. He's attempting on at the higher level of pride. And that's no doubt what would have happened with Mary. Mary would have been tempted as Jesus was. The devil would have hit her with everything he has, like he hit Jesus with everything he had, but of course he failed. And that's beautifully symbolized, Joe, in Revelation chapter 12. And a shameless plug for my book. I had fun writing that section where I talk about how in Revelation 12, Mary is clearly revealed to be the new Eve. You have the woman who gives birth to Jesus in verses 4 and 5, and then to all of us in verse 17. But you also have that sort of, you know, throwback there to Genesis chapter 3 and the fall. You have the dragon mentioned, you know, the devil and so forth. You have the three main characters in Genesis 3 are recapitulated in Revelation. You've got the new Adam, the new Eve, and you have the devil, the dragon. And so, Joe, it's fascinating to look at those two chapters, as I do in the book, and you see the three main characters. But in the Old Testament, the devil comes after Eve and gets her, right? She succumbs to the temptation and she falls. But in Revelation 12, she comes after who? The woman. I mean, it's an overt, the inspired author here, St. John, is just overtly doing the parallel here between Genesis 3 and Revelation 12. The devil comes after the woman in verse 13, but this time he can't get her to sin. He mm-hmm. does not. And so what? He's angry. He goes after her children. In Revelation chapter 12, verse 13 and down to 17, the devil then comes after us because he couldn't touch the son and he couldn't touch the mother. Anyway, I went beyond your question there, Joe, but I hope that gets at it.
Appreciate the call.